You ever hang out with a normal person, like didn't have any drama in their life, and they tell you a story? Oh my God, me and the family went to a restaurant, and we got there, and my dad ordered wine, and I'm like, oh shit, here we go. And he had like two glasses, and then he got really goofy and funny, and then he felt so weird in the parking lot. He gave my brother the keys, and he was only 16, and he drove home, and I'm like, oh shit, what happened? Nothing, we made it home safe. We can't hang out. Ever. There was no, like, no domestic violence in the parking lot or nothing? What are you talking about? Nice meeting you. I'm fucking out. Thanks for laughing so far. You know, and you know, we had family trips and stuff, but again, they were like, other kids told him, I was like, oh my God, I was loading the car and I put the suitcase on top of the cooler and my dad got all mad at me. What happened? Nothing. He just said, don't do it again. Like, he didn't just pop you in the back of the head really hard? No. We can't fucking hang out then. My dad would get us in the car, and he always bought one of those styrofoam coolers. Yes. And he knew what it did, but he always bought one. You know, it was like his Joker. It was, you ever, did anyone ever have one of those cars on the thing in a long trip? Just it made that high-pitched screeching noise that it could actually make Vikings sterile. And he knew what it did, and yet he would get it. You know, he always had to have a styrofoam cooler in the car to keep his road beer fresh. I thought that was an every family thing till I was like 12. And I was having dinner at my friend Glenn John's house, and I go, what does your dad do with his road beer? And the whole family was like, what? And it was so bad for my brother and I, because we couldn't talk him out of the car. He would just buy them because they were cheap, whatever. And my brother and I'd be in the backseat, and we would just see my dad. It was almost like a werewolf thing. We'd be driving the car, and as the thing was making noise, he'd just, And my brother and I, we'd just spread way out in the seat, up against the door. Because when he was drunk, we'd measured his reach. That thing would just keep going. And then about like 100 miles in any trip, he'd just go, give me the lid, that goddamn thing! And then out the window. And then my brother and I would turn around and watch the accident behind us.